Alrighty, Swiftpoint-ers, so let's talk about input combinations. This is a feature that has been a part of the Swiftpoint Z series since day one, but hasn't been brought to the forefront that often. Well, today that changes. So our competitors have their own versions of input combinations, but in our opinion, they just aren't that good. But don't tell them that. Oh wait, this video is on YouTube, they'll see it. G'day Logitech, Razer, Roccat, how's it? So Logitech has what they call GShift, Razer has what they call Hypershift, and Roccat has what they call Easy Shift. While Razer's Hypershift, Logitech's GShift, and Roccat's Easy Shift are great, input combinations on the Z2 takes it to another level. With the Z2 and the X1 control panel, you can create complex action sequences with ease, enjoy fluid transitions between tasks, and harness the full power of your mouse and all of its buttons, all without sacrificing other features or buttons on your mouse. So, what are input combinations? Great question. Input combinations, as the name suggests, empowers you to create dynamic sequences of actions that achieve precisely the outcomes you desire. This feature allows you to string together a series of commands that you may use often within a game or software. Now, allow me to clearly showcase what we mean by input combinations with showing you how to create an input combination within the X1 control panel and your mouse, and also how to activate it. Inside the X1 control panel, we are going to click on left click and then on add input. A new pop-up window will appear and we're going to change deep click to button, and you will see that the window next to it has changed. We are now going to click on the drop down and change left button to bottom thumb. Close that window down and now click on the next drop down that currently says none, and I'm going to type cut. This has now added cut as an action that can be triggered at the same time of holding down the left click button. This, of course, is an input combination that can be performed when highlighting text to then be deleted. Now, in my desktop profile, I have paste bound to my upper thumb. If I wanted to paste the text that I just cut back into the document or note, I can do so by simply pressing my top thumb button to paste it back in. So let me share some extra and super basic input combinations with you to give you a sense of what we are talking about here. Now, these examples will stretch across gaming and software. Now, to start with, for example, PUBG and Rainbow Six allow you to aim and lean from behind trees or the corner of a building. You can keep aim bound to the right click button and use your lower thumb button to lean left or your upper thumb button to lean right. And of course, keeping your left finger free and open to tap and or press and hold for firing your weapon. Now, within Fortnite builds that I personally don't play often, you can hold down left click to fire your weapon and lay some rounds into your opponent before flicking your top thumb button to build a wall, then pressing your right fingertip button to confirm the build and your lower thumb button to quit out of build mode, all while holding down the left click to then bring your gun back out and continue shooting. Now, within Canva that I use every day for content creation, I have a couple of super handy input combinations assigned to my mouse that use gestures. These are to quickly and easily change the position and or layer of an image or design that I'm working on, or to quickly and easily zoom in and out of my design on my screen. The layer input combination is achieved by pressing my rear edge button and moving my mouse backwards and forwards. The zoom in input combination is done the exact same way, but by pressing my front edge button. So there you have it, input combinations. As mentioned at the beginning of this video, this isn't a new feature as it has been available since the launch of the original Z and is available now for those of you who own an original Z Tracer or Creator. We at Swiftpoint have not done a very good job at telling you, the users, about this particular feature and showing it off for that matter. So what are you waiting for? Get into your X1 control panel and start playing around. We would love to hear from you down in the comments around what crazy and wonderful combinations you have come up with. And better still, if you have ones for games and or software that I do not play or use and that you think would be beneficial for more users, then I'd love to invite you to join our awesome and super vocal Facebook community filled with other like-minded Swiftpoint Classic Grip users. But for now, I'll say thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in the next video.